Well, medical history is made here in Phoenix. For the very first time, doctors stop a pregnant woman's heart to operate on her brain. It took place at Barrow Neurological Institute at St. Joseph's Hospital.
Still weak and tired from surgery, Cheryl Jones is also somewhat surprised. She's now in the medical record books. Surgeon Dr. Robert Spetzler stopped her heart by dramatically lowering her body temperature and then draining most of her blood.
So that's one aspect, is to prevent the bleeding, because obviously if you have no blood pressure in there and the balloon is collapsed, it's not going to burst on you.
A 5-year-old Arizona girl has Valley doctors believing in miracles.
Today, doctors at Barrow Neurological Institute explained how the surgery worked to patch the major artery back together.
It bleeds inside the skull. The pressures will go so high that the brain won't be able to survive.
And now, CJ's story, a Dateline special. Here is Jane Pauley.
Good evening. If your child was seriously ill and there was a treatment that could help or even be a cure, is there any question you'd try it?
Robert Spetzler, director of the renowned Barrow Neurological Institute in Phoenix.
I said initial success, they have received enough patients so that they can make advances based on experience.
This is 12 News at 10.
To be a brain surgeon, you need years of medical school. And for some, legs of steel.
The head of the Barrow Institute has a unique way of training surgeons, a hike across the Grand Canyon, rim to rim. Check it out.
Having hiked Mount Rainier and Kilimanjaro himself, Dr. Spetzler challenges Barrow staff to cross the Grand Canyon with him, a 23-mile hike.
Fox 10 News is back.
A Norwegian woman is preparing to return home after a life-changing, life-saving surgery at the Barrow Neurological Institute.
I'm feeling surprisingly good.
She was facing a very risky proposition.
This is the KTLA Morning News, First Edition.
Dr. Spetzler is also a teacher, but his students aren't here in the operating room. They're down the hall in a cutting-edge classroom, viewing every detail of the surgery on huge TV screens. They say it's actually better than being there.
I can actually make eye contact.
From NBC News World Headquarters in New York, this is NBC Nightly News with Brian Williams.
When all hope appeared to be lost, his family prepared themselves to let him go. Until one night, something extraordinary happened.
That night, Sam stunned everyone by following a command. Holding up his two fingers.
Now, that may not seem like a lot to you, but in fact, to be able to hold up two fingers means they're receiving the signal.
Anthony Vasquez began last season pitching for the Seattle Mariners AAA team. He was making steady progress until one night last November. Doctors had found something, a rare lesion called an arterial venous malformation, or AVM.
Left side of the brain, right here. That's basically where this was located.
This is NBC Nightly News. From NBC News World Headquarters.
Muhammad Ali will be remembered for the major part he played in promoting awareness of and research on Parkinson's disease.
He used his incredible presence for the betterment of society.
Brett turned to world-renowned brain surgeon Dr. Robert Spetzler as his only hope of survival.
His aneurysm is bad. On a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being the worst, I would put this as a 9.
Brett's recovery has been impressive. Today, he and Anne are finally getting married.